Dear students, today discussing unit number 1, testing of hypothesis. In the class we are discussing the Z test for the single mean. There are two types of tests will be there, no? One will be small test and another will be Z test. When we can use Z test mean? If a sample size is more than 30, we can use the Z test. If a sample size will be less than 30, we can use only T test. But today class we are discussing the Z test only. Before going to the Z test problem, we can discussing the table value. There is no table value given in our examination. All we can remain Z test. There are three types will be there, no? Level of significance 1%, 5%, 10%. The critical value, there are two tail tests, right tail test and left tail test. Mostly we can use the two tail test only. If a two tail test at 1% level of significance, the modulus Z value will be 2.58, and then 5% level of significance will be 1.96, and 10% will be 1.645. If we can use a right tail test means Z equal to 2.33, and 5% will be 1.645, 10% will be 1.28. For left tail mean same thing, put the negative number, negative value, that's all. -2.33, -1.645, -1.22. Started the problem in Z test. See, a problem in a 900 members has been mean value will be 3.4 centimeter and the standard deviation will be 2.61. So sample from a large population of mean 3.25 and the standard deviation will be 2.61. Same thing here. What is here asking the problem? The sample size will be large population of mean will be 3.25. The standard deviation will be 2.61. What is asking? So and also bracket we can put the test at the what we have to, we can use the 5% level of significance. At the 5% level of significance is a modulus of Z alpha, what is it given, 1.96 will be less than, we can check test the value. That's all. So first of all, it is a Z test because it is a sample size will be 900. The sample size will be more than 30, no? We can use the Z test. There is no mention at all Z test or T test. We should find out the Z test or T test. So the sample size will be more than 30. We can use the Z test for single mean only. So here n size will be 900, and there are two types of mean will be. One will be sample mean, another one will be population mean. So here sample mean will be 3.4, and the population mean will be 3.25. Sample have the sample from the members only, no? So that's why I put in the X bar equal to 3.4, and the population mean will be given 3.25, given the problem will be large population in the mentioned here, no? Large population, see if a population will be given. Okay, at a 5% level of significance, step 1, H naught will be null hypothesis. You can take the population value will be mu equal to 3.25. step 2, alternate hypothesis, mu not equal to 3.25. can use a mu equal to and a mu not equal to, therefore we can use only two tail test only. So step 3 will be alpha at the 5% level of significance. Step 4 will be, can use the formula. What is the formula here now? Z test, Z equal to x bar minus mu divided by s divided by root of n. Here sample size will be, n will be 900, and the standard deviation will be 2.61, the sample mean will be 3.4, and the population mean will be 3.25. just substitute, got the value will be 1.724. then step 5 will be conclusion, can conclude the value here. So if a Z of alpha by 2 and Z less than alpha, then Z of alpha by 2, here accept the H naught because the calculated value will be 1.724, but table value will be 1.96. obviously table value will be highest comparatively the calculated value, but a table value will be 1.96. so therefore here the problem will be accept the H naught. And also one more step will be, we should find out the confidence limit. So here 95% confidence limit, no? So here formula will be x bar plus or minus 1.96 s divided by root n. So here 95% confidence level, we can use the 5% level of significance. The 5% level of significance value will be 1.96. just substitute here, x bar plus or minus 1.96 s divided by root of n. The substitute, can got the value will be 3.51 and 3.2295.
problem will be over.
Thank you. The next problem will be same type. The problem will be the mean lifetime of a sample of 100 light bulbs produced by a company, computed to be 1570 hours with a standard deviation of 120 hours. The mu will be mean lifetime of all the bulbs produced by the company. You test the hypothesis. Mu equal to 1600 hours. Directly given mu equal to 1600 hours. Against the alternate hypothesis will be mu not equal to 1600 hours. Directly given, it is a two-tailed test because mu equal to 1600 and the alternative will be not equal to 1600 hours. So we can use a two-tailed test at a 5% level of significance. This problem we can conclude the both alpha equal to 5% and 1% also. See, with alpha equal to 0.05 and also 0.01. So problem will be, here size will be n equal to 100. We can use the set test. So here population mean will be 1600 and the standard deviation will be 120 and the sample mean is given 1570 hours. Alpha can check the 5% and also 1% level of significance. Step 1 will be the null hypothesis mu equal to 1600 and alternate hypothesis mu not equal to 1600. Can use the two-tailed test. Step 3 will be we can conclude the 5% and also 1%. So step 4 we can apply the formula. Z is equal to x bar minus mu divided by s divided by root n. Substitute the value, you got the value will be minus 2.5. Minus 2.5 means you can take the only the modulus value. So automatically you can take the plus 2.5. So step 5 will be conclusion. So similarly here now before the problem, you should find out the z minus of z alpha by 2 less than z alpha by 2. Here it's also, here calculated value will be 2.5. Can conclude the two types. One will be 5% level of significance and another one will be 1% level of significance. First discuss the 5% level of significance. 5% level of significance, the table value will be remainder now 1.96 and here calculated value will be 2.5. So comparatively table value will be lesser, calculated value will be higher. So automatically, so here reject the H0 at a 5% level of significance. Then go to the second step. Here at a 1% level of significance, the calculated value will be, see there, calculated value will be 2.5, but the table value will be 2.58. The table value will be highest for the 1% level of significance. So here automatically here calculated value will be less, table value will be highest. So therefore we accept the H0 at a 1% level of significance. At the 5% level of significance, H0 will be rejected, but 1% level of significance, H0 will be accepted. Thank you.